Hi, this is a watercolour I did as a demo some months ago. Very simple. Well, as simple as a watercolour. See, Norfolk coast. The buildings I put too close to this because that would have gone by now with all the storms that we had on the east coast. It's Norfolk is the East Anglian coast of UK, coast closest to or close to Europe. Just simple fields and some trees, sky, a road, very simple. I'll pin that above my board, then I can refer to it as I go. I won't do a copy, exact copy, but just something to work to. So we're using acrylic, which I seem to be enjoying. So I'll go with the flow. I've got some of this, I don't know if I'd use, I'll squeeze some of that. It does work. KY jelly has more than one use. It helps the paint stay moist a bit longer than it would otherwise, because being acrylic it dries very quickly. It's a water-based lubricant, and acrylic being water-based. So there we are. I've had one or two comments on it that suggested it. So I'm going to go with it. Right, I'll put in the sky as quickly as I can. I don't really want to do this in two parts, but the colours I'm using are yellow ochre, lemon yellow, white, Indian red or light red oxide, alizarin crimson, ultramarine, KY jelly and some black. I'll need to squeeze. I'm using a stay wet palette, Masters and Stay Wet palette. And the membrane I'm using underneath, I've got a sponge that's supplied. But it does tend, it's very good. It soaks the water up through it, but allows, well, it soaks the paint up, the water up, but stops the paint from slipping through. It's very good. You can use these palettes for oil paints. Right, so we'll start off with a bit of ultramarine in the sky. I don't want a really too blue sky. So now the board, I've been asked several times about what I'm using on this. It's hardboard, masonite. I think that's what they're called in America. I'll just put in a bit of blue here to start with. I've roughed the smooth side up with sandpaper, of course, very coarse sandpaper. Sort of stuff you put in a belt sander. And I've treated it with a PVA or acrylic matte varnish, which I've mixed with, I've brushed in some plaster of Paris to make a bit of a toothy surface for the paint to stick to. I'll just take a bit darker than that. So it's nice if to get the paint to stay moist for quite a time, so dip in with the jelly and in with the paint. I'm not going for too much impasto at the moment, I'm just roughing it in the sky. And it's going to come down quite low, the horizon. And I'll put some nice light in there and some darker shadows, shadow on clouds. Let's go in with some ochre now and a bit of light red. So this will blend a bit. Norfolk, down to there, about there, for the horizon of the sea. And I'll put some clouds over this. Touch of the jelly. Slight hill there. Norfolk is a very flat county. Apart from the north coast where you've got Cromer, East and West London, which are higher than the average coast. Right, get some oak, a bit of oak and a bit of warm cloud cover. Some clouds underneath. It's still moist, so it's working. Right, now I'll mix in a bit of alizarin crimson and ultramarine. And it's a bit dark in there. Coming over the sea there. So clean that brush and go back more with my light colours. Now I've got three lots of light clouds here, and that's not what we're after at all. We've got a bit more of this cloud behind the cloud shadow. More lights, I think more light cloud. Oh look, hair. If you get any hairs, you pull them off, but they'll stick. More light there. A bit of jelly. Red, bit of light red, bit of ochre. As for painting, holding a brush like that, as distinct from that, or like that, well away from the canvas, bored. Not for me, really. I can't get it within an inch of where I want it to go. The way I do it, it suits me. There are no rules. Good painting practice may be, but not how you hold your influence. As long as you can make yourself understood, that's fine. Now, that's quite a good windy sort of sky. Put a bit more blue back, I think. How's it going? Just open this up a little bit with blue. So I want a nice summery sky. No great threats on here. About my light colour. You need plenty of rag. I keep paint or clean the paint out of the bristles near the ferrule because that eventually will split your brushes right across your bristles. It won't split the individual bristles, but it will destroy the use of the brush. But the same goes for oil painting as well. But let's just put in some a bit more light. Having said that, I was just holding the brush like this now. Let's just change. Sorry if I shake them. I can't see my. It's a little bit brown. Let's do it. I'm going to manual focus this. So it makes any difference. Yeah, this is right. I'll put in a bit of horizon of trees here, a bit of blue, a bit of yellow. I'll change it. I'll put some, if I can find it. I've got some burnt umber around here somewhere. Oh, Venetian red. I just bought a load of red and I've got some Venetian red. Oh well, this is what we find, burnt umber. Well, that's burnt sienna. Burnt sienna. Bear with me a moment while I look for the burnt umber. I didn't have much. I need to buy some, just looking down in my drawer. Oh, here it is. I'm going to mix the black umber and lemon yellow to try to give a nice background colour. But whatever I put on, I can change. So a bit of black. Bit of umber, lemon yellow. Oh, I thought I'd mix a bit of blue in with that because that's a bit. Right, let's. So we've got that coming down there. Distance here. I'll do some of the sort of trees and just the shrubby stuff there. Now we'll put a big wedge of trees in. Just put sort of that background colour in there. Okay, that'll do. Just touching some, of course, here. Now, the house, you know, I'm going to have to put in further in, I think, because I'll change all this. I'm not really happy with that. But I want to put in the house now. Little half inch flat brush. I will modify this red with a bit of white, so we'll put there, slightly bluer. A nice dark in there. Well, I can modify those in a moment. Let's put in some cliff sort of stuff. They'll be slightly looking down on this, that's a now we're going to put a bit of a beach in there. Have a bit of blue, bit of ochre. Sort of a cool grey. seems fairly strange. I'm mixing that with a bit of the KY. So I want to blend in there. Bit of ochre. This is a bit of a stiffer brush on there. Bit of burnt umber and ochre beach going in here. Sandy colour. So if I'm marking. I'll let that dry off a bit. Just trying to show some breakers there. But I'll go over that. But I want to go back to the landscape a bit. So a mix of lights and darks and just mix loads of colours in this. Nice greeny colours. If I can complete this with doing this sort of painting, that'll be okay. So we've got this path coming down. Right, a bit of a bit of darker green. Oh, that's mixing black with the lemon yellow. See, a lovely. Don't mix black with lemon yellow. Mix lemon yellow with black. Get a little bit of. No, that's wrong. A nice wedge of yellow, and just add a little bit of black to it. If you go the other way, it'll stay black. It's funny that, but it does happen. Let's just change that. Let's do a bit of dark on the edge of the road here. Greens. Well, this isn't cliff here, this is the edge of the cliff, but I want that to show as a graphs. I've got to put some trees either side of this, of those houses, buildings. So use a bit of a rougher brush now. Right, coming on. That wasn't very clever, was it? Right, I'm going to put that road in with some similar colour to the background. Which is burnt umber, basically. And just sort of a rough road, really. Like that. Oh, that'll be the bit. I'll put the little breaking, the tide, the high tide or low tide, back. Right, let's. Need to model some of this now a little bit. So. So this is just breaking up the outline of this land here. Just while undulating, get some light on there, on that horizon, against the trees, counterchange. Nice little dry. Nice and light across there. Well, right, I've got to put in some trees, or sort of trees, bushy elderberry, elderflower trees. So I'll brown, yellow, bit of black, could be Payne's grey, but that's too dark really. So let's just right, okay, that's a bit of basis of that. So I need the one on the left to be just a little bit bigger than the one on the left. And then I can lighten the roof. Now all I've got is the light red and sienna, ochre. Let's get keep the brushes nice and soft in the water, nice and clean in the water. And we'll get in some lighter colours on the right by the by those buildings. one. I need to lighten up the colour of the road, really. But it was a good colour. You can use, well, in watercolour we use light red and blue. A bit more texture, a little bit of detail, and a bit on here. So if I put a little bit of blue up there, that might throw that back a little bit. Just use a bit of ultramarine. Mixed with alizarin crimson, a bit of white, just a good shadow colour. It's a bright dark rather than the muddy one with the black. Get some warmer colours in here. Well, I've put in some grasses here, catching the now, the darker green in the foreground here. Don't want to put a lot of detail in here, but I just want it to be stronger so that it'll look nearer. Just stroking up with the brush here creates some texture in the foreground. now. Use a small brush here, and I'm going to put in a little bit of this will show, but whether I lose my. Just trying to show the wet on the distant beach here. Now some ochre. I think this sea might be just a little bit too dark, so we'll endeavour to lighten this up a little bit. A bit of blue, yellow ochre, just to cure the blue, to get it lighter. Just using a bit of blue there. Mm-hmm. It looks all right there, but get one or two larger ones in here. Oh, we just put some greens in there, I think. I'm not going to put the figure in. This was very easy to do with the watercolour. So. I quite like that with as it is as a just a wedge. I'm trying to keep it as simple as possible, but I'm not sure it's that is looking too dull. Not too bad there. That's maybe I'm using too small a brush there. Let's go with that again. So I'll go over with some yellow ochre. There, vary it with some just needed brightening up. Catching the light. That has not worked out as well as I'd hoped. That I wanted to show the edge of the cliff there. Maybe if I bring over the grass to further up here, sticking out the like dunes. leave some yellow ochre. Raw sienna, well, plenty of raw sienna. Oh, let's use it. It's slightly darker than the unusual. That's just slightly darker than the yellow ochre that I was using. Right. just trying to break up the outline of, well, not the outline, the surface. Right, let's see if I can get in some bit of detail. I forgot to put some little chimney spots. Okay. I haven't paid great attention to where the light's coming from, but it seems to be coming from there, so let's just drag over some lighter colour. Okay. Maybe we can do the same with it. I'm using this brush rather than the brush I was using for that stipple the other day. Let's just go back to the dark. Dark green. Well, that'll do. Let's give it a signature. I'll find a frame if I can. I meant to do that first, but see if I've got one. If not, no, I don't seem to have one. But I do have. Amount. It's I won't show you what I copied it. It doesn't copy from any matter. It's I'll put it in one of these. Oops. Yeah, that'll work. Let's get a bit of masking tape. Hold on. Hope it doesn't fall down on us. Well, it more or less shows a bit of the sea. See if I've got a better mount. Or a longer one. I've got some dirtyish ones, but this might be better. Oops. A bit better. Well, there we are, just a simple, wasn't so simple, was it? How's that? I'll zoom in. Go back to automatic focus. Right, there we are. So there's my bit of distant trees, nearer trees. See, in the end, those trees were brought to life by just a few slashes with a brush. But that's that side, that was quite good. I struggled with this there. But when I see it in a mount, it looks quite dramatic, doesn't it? It's a little Edward Seago type of scene. So I think we'll let that go. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.